people differ in the way they see and experience the world, and these differences affect their politics, not surprisingly. But we've got all kinds of predispositions. Some of these we're aware of. We know our tendencies. We know whether we're introverts or extroverts. But other things we're really not even aware of. And these things that are non-conscious can actually affect our political beliefs. A lot of people don't have these predispositions I've been describing tonight. They're in the middle. They're uncertain. They haven't thought about issues a lot. So those are people who are in play, and we can try to persuade them. But I would caution against really trying to sit down and convert somebody who's firmly on the other side. I mean, that just rarely does much good. They're not going to break down in a kind of Perry Mason style with their head in their hands and say, oh my God, you're right. We need to view these biological differences as something other than failings. We need to view our opponents as not being morally or intellectually deficient, necessarily. I mean, they might be, but it may be that they're just different, and I think we need to recognize that.